Alright, this is a circle. Our job is to find its center and its radius, alright? So here we go. We know what we need to do. Think back in your memory. You need to
Complete
the square. So we're gonna put the X's together and we're gonna leave a blank. We're gonna put our Y's together. We're gonna leave a blank. This is not in your notes, kids. You might want to get out a piece of paper and work through this. Notice I moved the 3 to the other side, right? So here we go. Half of 6 is 3 and 3 squared is 9. So those of you that are not adding the right number need to pay attention. Half of this squared. Now we're gonna do the same thing here. Half of 12 squared, 36. Now the whole reason that you did that is so that you could write this like this. So what would be in here? X plus, this sign always matches, 3. You use X and 3. And then here we're going to do the same thing, only we're going to do Y plus 6. We use the Y squared and the 36 to get these numbers. Equal to 48. Just add them up. So my center, when I do a circle, I need the center and the radius. The center is at negative 3, negative 6. It is the opposite of what's in the parentheses, and that's true for every shape. Parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. It's the opposite of what you got in here. What's your radius? Square root of 48, which is 4 root 3, thank you. 16 times 3, 4 root 3. Any question about the circle? All right, now we're going to the next one, which is the parabola. Now, that equation will always look like that. I will have it set up for you. You do not have to do anything with the equation. It will be ready for you, okay? Now, here, what do I ask you for? I ask you for vertex, focus, directrix, and focal width. Vertex, focus, directrix, focal width. That's what we need to know for a parabola. These two, if you don't throw them in, you're just crazy because these are straight from the equation. What's your vertex?
Negative 1, negative 2.
This is the tricky one. We have to be careful. It is always X, comma, Y, right? We got to be careful about that. This, what's this? 4, not negative. Focal width, positive number. Now, is the negative important? Yes, but it's not the focal width. The focal width is 4. Got it? That number right there. Now, to find the other ones, it's a little harder. You told me my vertex is at negative 1, negative 2. My focus, I'm going to start here, and I'm going to count either left, right, up, or down. In order to know which way to go to get my focus point, I need to know which way this thing opens. Which way does this one open? Left. You are right. Correct. How do we know it opens to the left? It's a y squared and it's negative. Y squared is sideways. Negative means left. So I need to back up some distance to get my focus point. So I'm going to take, I don't know how many steps, this way to get my focus point. How do I figure out how many steps I need to take? 4P. This number right here is always 4P. So if 4P is 4 take or leave the negative, it doesn't matter at this point. If 4P is 4, then we're backing up one step. P is 1. If you start at negative 1, negative 2, and back up one step, where will you be? Negative 2, negative 2. That's your focus. Your focus is negative 2, negative 2. You backed up one step. Okay? Now, if I backed up a step for my focus, then I'm going to go forward a step, one step, same distance, for my directrix. That's a line. I know if you go forward, you might think, oh, that's 0, negative 2. That point is 0, negative 2, but the equation is x equals 0. The directrix is an equation. All right? Then we've got the ellipse. And the ellipse looks like this. And again, that equation will look like that. It will be set up for you. You won't have to do anything to it. The information that I've been asking you for the ellipse is the center, the vertices, the foci, the major axis, and the minor axis. That's the information that we need for an ellipse. You should be able to fill that one in the snap of a finger. Where's your center? Negative 1, negative 3. Now, actually the vertices are pretty easy too. Remember how you find the vertices? The vertices are those points that you connect to make the oval. You remember how you figure out where you put those? You start here and you do some counting. You remember how you figure out how far to count? Square root of these guys. So this 16 tells me I'm going to count sideways. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So again, you can use graph paper if you want. You're counting 4 this way. So this point would be 5, negative 3. And this one would be 3, negative 3. Very, very good. Now, see the 25 right there? That tells me I'm going to go up and down 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That puts me where?
4, negative 3.
Negative 1, comma 2. I went up 5. And this one's going to be negative 1, comma negative 8. All right, so I'm going to connect these dots. There it is. Now, my picture is not really good, so it's kind of hard to tell, but you should know which one's the long one, up and down or sideways? Up and down. Because I went up and down 5, and I only went sideways 4. So my major axis, my up and down, I went up and down 5. So this is 10. And I went sideways 4, so this is 8. We're talking about the length of the major and the length of the minor. That's what this means. Is that okay with everybody? Now, that's not too bad. Oh, these 4 points, I put them on my picture, but I didn't write them down. You get it, right? Those are the vertices. Okay. That's all pretty easy. This one is kind of tricky. This is the one. Remember, it's somewhere on the major axis. It's always on the long axis. Now, what do we know about these points? Look at all of them here in a line. What do we know about them? X is negative 1. So I'm going to go ahead and write that down so that even if I screw the rest of it up, I'm going to get half credit. Now, to figure out the rest of the point, I need to know how far up and down to travel. That distance is the center to the focus. How far from the center up to the focus? Well, take a look at your equation. Who remembers how to do that? Square root of the 25 minus 16, that works out. That's 3, sometimes it's a radical. This one was nice, it's 3. So I'm gonna start here and go up 3. Well, I drew it kind of wrong. If I go up 3, where will I be?
0,
negative 1, 0. And if I go down 3, I'll be at negative 1, negative 6. That's a recap. Now get your note sheets out. We're on page 56. And we are ready for problem B.
Should I keep those words inside?
So we are on our note sheets, or page 56, problem B. Hyperbolas are the biggest in terms of stuff defined.
You said 56,
right? You need to find the center, the vertices, the foci, the asymptotes, the transverse axis, and the conjugate axis. We have lots of information we need to find. Who can tell me why I know that equation is a hyperbola? What is the clue? It's a subtraction. Hyperbolas are built just like ellipses, except that's a minus instead of a plus. Okay? Now, when I say they're built the same way, we handle them the same way. Where's the center of this guy? 0, 0. You remember that the center is at 0, 0. Well, it's at 0 when you don't have anything added or subtracted in those parentheses. Right? So here's my center. What's that 25 right there tell me? Count which way? Up and down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. What's that 4 tell me? Sideways 2. Got it? Now, what do I do with these 4 points? This is a hyperbola.
Rectangle.
Don't connect them with an oval. What do we connect them with?
A rectangle.
A rectangle. So you're going to make a rectangle through those 4 points. Those 4 points are the same points you would have connected with the oval, but it's a hyperbola, so we're making a rectangle. Now, what did I do that for? What do I use that rectangle for? To draw in my diagonals, which are the asymptotes. So you're going to draw in your diagonals. Just like that. Those are the asymptotes. Now we're going to construct the hyperbola. I'm going to draw my hyperbola. Now what are my choices? I can draw the big fat one on the sides in between these lines. See how big and fat that would be? Or I could draw the little skinny one on the inside, up and down. How do I know whether I'm going to draw a sideways hyperbola or an up and down one? Exactly. And what's the rule? That's right. When y squared comes first, this guy comes first, that means my hyperbola is opening like this. and your hyperbola starts on the box. So when you drew this box, it starts at the top and the bottom of the box. If it opened sideways, it would start on the left and the right of the box. These two points, the top and the bottom of the box, are called the vertices. So your vertices are 0, negative 5, and 0, 5. How many vertices are there? 2. These guys are not vertices. Are they on the blue curve? Nope. This axis that connects the vertices is called the transverse axis. It connects the vertices. How long is my transverse axis? 10. It connects the vertices. The other axis is called the conjugate axis, and it is simply the width of the box, the width of the rectangle, so it would be 4.
So it's still like a major and a minor.
What?
So it's still like a major and a minor.
It's like a major and a minor, except the transverse axis can actually be shorter. It can be. The transverse axis doesn't have anything to do with length. It has to do with those are the vertices, wherever they are. So in this case, these are my vertices, so that's automatically going to be transverse. If my hyperbola looked like this, that would be the transverse. Okay, so far, so good. Now what? Now I need my foci. They're going to be inside here somewhere. Would you agree with that? Now, just like before, things start to get complicated. It's easy to get it all mixed up in your head. You may miss a couple of these questions. But you ought to get half credit. Because if you just pay attention to your picture, what do you know about those two points? They have 0. They're 0 comma, right? 0 comma something. So we're going to get half credit for just paying attention. The orientation of the picture. Now, like before, here's our center. This is where everything starts at the center. Not up here. Starts right here. And I need to know how far up to go. How far is it from the center to the focus? What do I do? Exactly. It's the square root of 25 plus 4, which is the square root of 29. That's different. In an ellipse, we subtract the denominators. In a hyperbola, we add them. There's a lot to remember. You got to keep all that straight, oh lordy. All right, now what does that mean? That means I start here and go up root 29. Well, since I'm starting at 0, if I go up root 29, isn't that just going to be root 29?
Yep.
And this one's going to be negative root 29. So my foci are at 0 root 29 and 0 negative root 29. Now the asymptotes. That means you've drawn them already. Now you're going to write the equation of them. So the asymptotes are going to be y equals mx plus b. They're lines. Let's look at one asymptote at a time. Let's look at this one. Can you tell me the slope of that?
5/2.
Very good. You counted up. When you built this box, up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5/2. There we go. So your slope is 5/2. you know a point that that line contains? Do you know an x and a y? 0, 0. So when I work that out, it looks like b just works out to be 0. Now that won't happen in the next problem, so I want you to get in the habit of working it out. But it's 5 has x plus 0. Now what about the other asymptote? Negative 5 has. You counted up 5 and left 2. So everything's going to be exactly the same, except that's a minus there. And when you work it out, you still get 0. So it's negative 5 halves x plus 0. There are your asymptotes. All right, now we got one, we got one more on this page to do. And it's a little bit bigger problem because it's not centered at the origin. Are we okay with this? All right, here we go. I'm gonna erase all this now. We're gonna start in with the next equation, which is a big one. All right, so here we go. Hang on to your hats. It's a lot of excitement here. Here we go.
Center at 3, negative. Center at 3, negative 1.
Exactly. Your center is at 3, negative 1. There we go. So now, for the first time, we are going to have a hyperbola, but the center is over here. So when I do my, when I do my counting, I am going to be doing it from that point. Does that make sense to you? All right, here we go. Let's count. Where am I going to count in this problem?
You're going over 4.
I'm going left and right 4, so it's one at a time. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And up and down, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now I haven't figured out all of those points because I'm not going to need all of them, but I do need to make a box out of them, right? So here comes my box. Here come my diagonals. Now I got to draw my hyperbola. Trade here. You don't want to get me in trouble, do you? You know, if an administrator walks by and you're sitting there with your eyes closed, I get like points off. You don't want to do that to me, do you? Okay. Sit up. It'll help if you sit up. I need to draw my hyperbola. How do I draw it?
Sideways.
How do we know this is a sideways hyperbola? X is first. Whatever letter comes first in the hyperbola, that's the way it opens. So this time is an X, it's opening sideways. Perfect. That means that these two big black points are the vertices. There are two of them. What are those two points?
-1, -1.
Remember, you counted 4, right? So -1, -1, and?
-1.
Perfect. Joseph, you following along?
Yeah.
Now, this axis then, this one, is called the transverse axis. How long is it? 8. B The other one that doesn't really count, but you built the box, it's 6. This time, my foci are here. Would everybody agree with that? What do I know about those points? Look at where they are. What's the situation there with those points? Their y coordinate is -1. All right, what about the x coordinate? Well, I need to figure out how far to move. How far is it from the center back to the focus? What do? Square root of 16 plus 9, which is the square root of 25. So 5, that worked out great. Usually it's a radical, like our last problem, it was root 29 or something. Usually it's a radical. This one worked out great. So I'm gonna start at the center. And I'm going to go back and forth 5. So if you start here at the center, everything builds from the center. If you start at the center and go forward 5, where are you? 8, -1. And what if you go backward 5?
-2, -1.
Very good. Everybody's still with me. This is a big problem. There's a lot with hyperbolas. They are the hardest. Got it? All right, what do we need? We need our asymptotes. And our asymptotes are going to be y equals mx plus b. So to write those equations, I need some room here. To write those equations, I need my slope. All right, now remember how you built the box. How many up did you count? 3. And how many over did you count? 4. So your slope is 3/4. Now, what are you going to put in for your point? What are you going to put in for y and x? -1 and 3. So -1 for the y, 3 for the x. Oh Lord, we're going to have fractions. It's part of life. Here we go. That's 3/1, so this would be 9/4. Now what do I need to do? Subtract 9/4. So b is going to equal -4/4 and -9/4. That's 4/4 if I get a common denominator. So what is that? -13/4. So y equals 3/4 x minus 13/4. We're not done, are we? What do we have to do now? Do the other one. What's the slope of the other one? This one was 3/4. What's the slope of the other one? -3/4. So I'm going to put -3/4 here. Can I use the same point? Yep. So now I'll have -9/4. Remember, that's 3/1 plus b. So I'm going to add 9/4. So what's that b going to be? -1 plus 9/4. What is that? 5/4. You'll have a calculator for this, so don't panic about the arithmetic. So we have 3/4 x plus 5/4 as our other asymptote.
That was a long problem.
That's a long problem. And now, the good news, there's another one!
Crazy.
All right, yes. You need to go to the nurse?
I think we all do.
Okay, why don't you run to the restroom, and then if you still don't feel well, go to the nurse, okay? All right, so here we go. Letter D. Okay, I'd like to do this one a little bit different because I see some of you look like you're bored. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to erase all this, right? I'm ready to erase all this. Am I? And I am going to have you come up whenever you feel inclined and put the various components up. So if you know where the center goes, you can come up and plot it. We'll talk about whether you're right or wrong, and then if you know where the vertices are, et cetera, et cetera. So let's see what you can fill in for all this information for the equation y squared over 81 minus x plus 5 squared over 16 equals 1. So, anybody feel like you know where the center is? Come up and put it up there. Anybody know where the vertices are? Put them up there. He's up and moving. I'm going to go ahead and put that on the graph. He says the center is at negative 5, 0. Would you agree with that? Yep. So he's going to plot it. Go and plot it for us. Everybody get the 0 part? And does everybody, you're right. Go ahead and plot it. And does everybody understand why he has them in that order? Negative 5, 0.
Yeah.
X, comma, Y. Okay. There he's got it. All right. Anybody feel like you want to do a next step? Gabby will. Oh, by the way, let's wish Gabby good luck. She's heading out, what, tomorrow morning?
Tomorrow morning at 4:15.
Tomorrow morning at 4:15, she's heading to Washington to win the national championship. For we the people. So good luck, Gabby. Now, you need to show us what you did there.
Okay.
Now, she is counting up and down 9. Does that make sense to everybody? She is also counting left and right 4. Does that make sense to everybody? And now she's building a box through those 4 points. So up and down 9, sideways 4, building a box. Now she's drawing in her...
Wouldn't it be right?
Now, she's kind of done a ton of work up here. Does everybody understand? She's gone sideways 4, up and down 9. She drew the hyperbola up and down this time. Was that the right move?
Yes.
Yes, because Y came first. So these 2 points right here are the vertices. These are the vertices. These are not. Those aren't anything. I didn't draw my picture through those points. I drew them through here. So those are my vertices. All right, can you fill in anything else? Trey's back. He says the transverse axis is 18 and the conjugate axis is 8. What do we think about that? Is that all right with everybody? Okay. Anybody feeling brave enough to do the foci? Liam? Liam's going to put his foci on there. So see if you can do this. Look where he's drawing them. Would you agree that's where they are? His green dots. What do we know about those green dots? The x coordinate is -5. So he's, look, see what he's doing? The x coordinate's -5. Now he's going to figure out how far up and down he has to go. There's his work. He says a square root of 97. Is he right? So he's going to count up 97 and down root 97. I mean, up root 97 and down root 97. Is that okay? Perfect. Thank you. Asymptotes. Let's see if we can get them done. Asymptotes. What's our slope? Asymptotes are going to be y equals mx plus b. The slope, Gabby says, is 9/4. Is she correct? Absolutely. So y equals mx plus b. We have 9/4. What point are we going to use? -5, 0. Always the center. This is 5/1. So when I multiply, I get -45/4. So B is 45/4. So your equation is 9/4 Y equals 9/4 X plus 45/4. You with me? Jake, everybody with me?
Yeah.
Now the other one is gonna be exactly the same, except what? The slope is going to be -9/4. I'll redo it. I'm going to use the same point. So when I multiply, I get 45/4 plus b. So b is -45/4. So my other line is -9/4 x minus 45/4. There are my gas codes. Good work. Good work. Chris, can you pop that off? Thank you. And hand it